afford. There are
Well, guys, it's actually loading in. I cannot believe it. Give me a minute here. I'm going to set up a private stream for a couple friends real fast. Okay. I don't know, we'll see. I may just sit at this loading screen forever. You never know. Well, let's see if it's doing anything. Something tells me it's not, but hey. Yeah, server looks good. Invalid ID location, that typically means I'm not gonna get in. Oh no, it's working. Huh. Okay, well, just be patient, I guess, huh? I just want to do some more salvaging before I got to get off for the day. It's already 1 o'clock. Universe time, Tuesday, October 27th. A little bit off there on the time, guys. A little bit off. I still got an invalid location, though, so that's almost telling me I'm not going to get in. Let me check on something here. I just saw a highlight video from Board Gamer that said confirmed further delay. Let me see what he has to say.
Star Citizen now for 3.18 was released to Wave 1 PTU, meaning it's no longer NDA'd as a build, so we can actually talk about it. NDA being a non-disclosure agreement, we can show it, we can sort of play it. Eva Cardi, some content creators, RSI subscribers, and some of the most active players on the issue council now have access, sort of. Well, I say have access because there's kind of been some issues with this patch, and I want to talk about that along with confirmation that Alpha 3.18 Live will now be released in January 2023. So Clan Imperium posted at the start of their This Week in Star Citizen post, "We'd like to give you an update on Star Citizen Alpha 3.18. This upcoming milestone marks a giant technical leap forward on Star Citizen's journey to deliver real universal persistence, and we couldn't have it done without all of you. Thank you. The biggest task for us right now is getting everything running smoothly enough to release to the live servers. While we're close, we've determined that this will require a bit more time. Our current target is to open Alpha 3.18 on the PTU to all testers this week, so you can all dive in and check out the new content and technology over the holiday break. We'll then come back strong after the holidays and work to release to the live servers in January. So, there you have it. Open PTU and the servers to a critical issue that wasn't due to scaling, which is excellent news. In order to properly diagnose the issue, we suspended player access and dove into the state of things. While doing that, actions were taken to mitigate and recover the environment, and once everything was operational again, we opened the PTU back up. Now, I'd just like to say that their spin on what a great success is fantastic. What a good spin. Like, just basically saying, look, these are for testing when we release it to the PTU. Public test. All of you are helping us bring this behemoth to life. While our Eva Cardi testers on the front line are crucial to the process. Huge shout out. These releases to additional PTU waves are equally important. The additional traffic grants us the valuable opportunity to stress test under high loads and is the most efficient way of uncovering potential issues. And in this case, it was a massive victory for the teams here as we were able to uncover and diagnose key issues to help further prepare 3.18 for prime time. It's also important to note that we're keeping the servers region locked to the US for now and limiting the number of shards and instances so we can maintain concentrated traffic in a smaller environment, as this is the most effective use of our time for data collection for the time being. As a result, some of you will find you are unable to access the PTU, but a little persistence, no pun intended, usually does the trick. Of course, Alpha 3.18 testing introduces a radically different paradigm than what we have all been accustomed to in the previous years. There's going to be some choppy waters as we dial in the new systems in under load, so it's safe to expect various levels of instability, and the style of dynamic and reactive testing response you saw today will be the norm going forward in this PTU testing phase. With that said though, with your activity, support and enthusiasm, we're more confident than ever. So as of right now, the morning after the Wave 1 launch, when I try and log in to Wave 1 PTU, there are a lot of people ahead of me in the queue. Sort of like, I say lot, 200, I think, let me just log in quickly right now, 50, 53. That's a lot less than I had previously. Now,
Well, it's we almost got in. Let's give this another shot and see what happens. Wow, maybe. Holy smokes. I'm in. Like I need to find some water. Oh, I don't know the station that well at all. Let's run down here and see what we can find. I could always go to a bed and lay down and get to. Matter of fact, let's get that a shot. Let's do a check-in real quick. Room 4. There we go, we're set. Let's see what's on the ASOP terminals and see what we can take out and play around with. All right, I definitely want to do some more salvaging because I absolutely enjoyed that. This way, dummy. Well, let's go ahead and do the vulture again. It won't let me file a claim. Great, got duplicate. That would be why. So let's just hang out for a minute and wait it out. Interesting. Why did it go to that one?
Goodbye. Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
25 seconds. Yeah, Don, I'll show you how the salvaging works as long as I can find a ship out there that's stripped down. Yeah. Well, it's got me locked. Can't do anything again. Looks like we're gonna 30k. Oh god. Figures I just get in and bam, we go down. Well, we'll just try to get back in. BWN is stuck at 028. Come on, server. Kick in. It's a long one. Yep, we're down to pure zeros. Be any second now, I'm imagining. There it is. Ugh, come on. Jesus. Thank you. see if that's any better though. General Pi, okay, persistent, enter. And it actually took me in. So they're either doing something with the servers again, or I came in at a bad time. Let's see how long it takes to load this time. Oh, that wasn't bad. Hey Thossie, yeah, I sure am. It took a little bit for me to get in. Had a couple 30Ks as well, but it so far so good.
Welcome to the ASOL vehicle retrieval system.
See if my vulture's here. It is.
Vehicle selected. Stand by. Your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
Oh, the only thing I don't think I grabbed. That's right, I'll get it later. Was the, you need a multi-tool to stack your boxes. Nice little cabinet there. That's probably where I'll stick it and see if it persists or not. I don't know. Got a lot of targets out here yesterday, so let's hope we can find some again. Self-destruct. I love how it does that every time you do a scan. About where I found them yesterday, right in here. See how far I am away from the station. It's a maneuverable little ship. I love it. Sticking out yet. Gotta fix the squeaky chair of mine. I can hear it through the mic. One thing I did want to do, I wanted to go over to Microtech and skim the planet. There's supposed to be some downed ships over there, and that would be pretty cool to go over and salvage over there. Oops, I hit that one. It's so funny, yesterday I had no issues finding anything, and of course today, nothing yet. See how far away I am from the station. I should be okay. Should be some right in this belt again, just like yesterday. I came across from yesterday in a heartbeat, though. Thought I saw something out there, that's why I stopped. So far, it's a pretty impressive ship. I like the way it handles. I've had no issues with the ladders or the cargo or stacking the boxes when I made several salvage runs yesterday. You know, of course, the PTU is very unstable right now. We still can't sell our salvageables just yet, but I'm hoping they'll institute that before they release it. Well, I got a work thing coming on. Good, I don't have to answer it right now anyway, thank God. Yeah, I've got a dual stream running. I've got it running on YouTube, and I've got the private one going. Yeah, Donnie, the thing about the projects I'm on now is I can do them at any time I want to. Long as they're done by the end of the month, I'm set. And I've only got, I believe, 5, possibly 6, so about 20 hours total. This is another long jump. Yeah, I got 7 projects. Can't complain. Hey Steven. Yeah, it's running okay so far. I did 30K twice so far before I started to stream, and also once just a little while ago on this stream, but all in all, you know, for something that's not set and ready to go to the PU just yet, it's running surprisingly smooth. What I'm doing now is I'm going over to Microtech, because apparently if you just pick a random spot and go down and start scanning for ships, you can do some salvage right there on the planet side itself. So we're going to see if I can find anything. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks, Steven. Yeah, we're getting a little closer. It's still taking a bit. Yeah. Yeah, this is the Vulture. I don't have the reclaimer, so I can't test it out. Maybe later tonight when I'm on with the guys, if I get on, we'll be able to pull the two reclaimers that we have in the org out and see what we can do. Steven, did Brian contact you regarding the org? Yes, Steven, he sure did. Thanks for suggesting. I appreciate that. And for those of you watching on YouTube, I am dual streaming one private, one on YouTube as well. So that's why it appears by those watching YouTube I'm talking to myself. I assure you I am not. Let's just go ahead and fly her in. Why not? Be right back, guys.